every single time I come to youth, I'm in stitches, holding my stomach, my cheeks hurt. Like every single time I come, it's just a load of fun, so every memory is fun.
After all of having a week of all school, it's just knowing that every Friday you get to come to youth, and it's just the exciting highlight of your week pretty much. Yeah, it's good because everyone's on the same boat, and
so your highlight of youth group is actually youth group. Excellent.
One of my favourite memories would be like in the younger years when we were crossing up and getting public school, and after the study we used to just tell dirty jokes to each other, and Crookie would just love it. He'd froth on every single joke we told him, regardless of how bad it was.
G7 definitely, because I'd never been before, so it was heaps good. I liked all the talks and that we sung heaps, and it was just good. And my last one, so I'm sad that I'll never go on again, but yeah.
Year 12 Bible studies, from year 9, 10 and 11 they were like, had little like monkeys running around their head and they couldn't sit still for 10 minutes, but in year 12, yeah, God's been really good and really worked in their lives, and yeah, now they can actually sit through a Bible study.
Great. Okay, hi Michelle.
Giving each other haircuts at youth. There was one stage where Jake Lewis had just filthy shaved head, with Blake Hughes actually, filthy, just no hair, but the back was like filthy and ratty. They just looked straight out of Bankstown, and Scott had the worst bowl cut I'd ever seen in my life.
So filthy.
Just filthy, yeah. Filthy.
Well, hi Michelle Jackson, what is your highlight of youth group?
I'd say probably my first G7. When we all went down and we couldn't have a bonfire, so we just had a light and we all laid there and we all told each other our Bible verses. I came back like on fire for God, and I was just so pumped from it. It was just really encouraging.
I had the pleasure seeing these boys grow up since year 6 when we got them. It's been a privilege, and not just seeing grow up from boys, but going from boys to men of God.
Probably G7 or Wake Up.
You guys come over to my house.
I'd have to say Bible studies. Lots of fun. We get distracted, but it's good.
Just hang out with the guys, you know, study. That's pretty fun most of the time. So hang out with the boys in the Bible studies, learning about God and just having a laugh.
The day when I grew taller than Jess was a pretty good day.
Hey, hood off. Come on. No gangster. That's it. Looking good. Alright, first question, highlight. Best memory from youth group?
The best memory from youth group would have to be where... Can we start again?
So, I love seeing you all dress up, and I like dressing up too, it's heaps of fun.
G'day. I'm Jacob. And the best memory from youth group would have to be when froth originated. And we would have been in year 8 at the time, and yeah, the word froth came about and we were the originators of it.
Memory, I think one of them would be seeing Bryce become a Christian just this week actually. Yeah, nothing could top that. And also just seeing the way the boys that you worry about when they were younger, like a few of the boys when they were in year 7. Yeah, seeing them grow and seeing them become mature, and now longer not worrying about where they'll end up.
One thing that I've found heaps helpful through the talks, and that's always going to stick in my mind, is always being accountable for your Christian mates and always hanging around with Christian friends, because no matter what you do, you're always going to have Christian mates there to back you up and help you out, and you can do that for them. So circling yourself with Christian mates is always going to be a helpful option.
A verse we did tonight was always never let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, and I think as a group we've visited that verse quite a bit throughout the course of the 7 years or whatever, and I think it's a challenge every time.
It was in one of Rick's sermons, and he gave a really good analogy that was, he was saying that
our relationship with God is like a marriage. Like, because if we hurt our partner in a marriage, it doesn't mean that we're not married to them anymore. It just means that we've hurt them and they might be upset with us, but we're still friends. But yeah, it's the same with our relationship with God, that if we hurt him, it doesn't mean we're suddenly not Christians anymore. But we can, God will be hurt, but we can say sorry and then we can continue on our relationship with God.
You always trust in Jesus, although you can't see him and you can't hear him, you can still trust him.
I've been challenged through like leading the boys and through talks and Bible studies just to pay attention to the word and how important it is to people, like just seeing how much the guys need it and we all need it as Christians and as sinners. And yeah, just the boys really keep me on my toes, because sometimes I'll say something dodgy and they'll kind of pull me up on it, and that's just a testimony to how God's really worked in their lives.
Rely on God, keep him in control of your life, and make sure you're not.
Faith wherever and whenever, and I just thought that was really cool, like that we can't just have faith whenever we want, but we can have it, we must have it all the time.
Here's my hair.
It's beautiful, it's flowing.
Probably to trust Jesus above all, just put him first in every aspect of your life, and just always charge for him, no matter where you are, what you're doing, just put God first.
To love Jesus and serve him as much as I can, and to really cherish the relationships I have with people, and make sure that God is the centre of those relationships.
One of the things that I've enjoyed and learnt the most out of Bible studies would have to be just having my Christian brothers around me, just every single week, no matter what. Like, if you've had a crap week, you just rock up to youth and it just seems to get better straight away, right from the start of the study.
At G7, when we wrote down all things to put in our folders, which just supplied for us, I wrote down the Ten Commandments. We went through the whole thing, and it's just a good reference to look back on, and yeah.
Probably just stand up for what you believe in, you know, be a leader. You know, be that role model to Christians, non-Christians.
This one was from Jess's Bible study, and it's do not worry.
What it means to be a man of God. We did a whole term of Bible studies on the disciplines of a godly man, and they were a huge rebuke for me, and I know for the other leaders as well, and that's what I really remember from leading the Bible studies with the boys.
To give God all the glory, and everything that we do is to give glory to God. There's nothing that we do that should not be giving glory to God. And yeah, it's really exciting to think that we can give glory to God, but really scary at the same time to think that God will be looking at everything that we do to give him the glory. So it's a bit of a challenge and an excitement all at the same time.
Yeah, I learned a lot in the Bible studies, like God's word, it's great, but what I really cherish is conversations that come after it, especially with my mates. You know, like on the way home, I'll talk to my mate James, like just say and reflect, and we'll say, only recently becoming a Christian, we'll say, you know, reflect on why am I a Christian now, and what's stopping me, and all these things, you know, eventually led to my salvation. So that would be the biggest thing that I learned is, you know, what have I got to lose?
Stop. Make good friends in youth group, because the friends I've made in youth group are my closest friends I've ever had. And getting a good close relationship with your leaders as well, you're always, it's just gonna, because I know that when I finish youth, I'm always gonna have them to be around or hang out with. So make good friends in youth, because it's the best thing you'll ever do.
Always think twice. It's always God's way, not your way.
Rely on God in everything in your life. Make sure he's in control. And yeah, give all the glory to him. It's our purpose.
even when you're feeling heaps yuck and gross and stuff and you've had a horrible week, coming to youth, it's just like a big pick-me-up. It's just awesome that you can just come and you just feel recharged from it all, and all the people are just awesome and encouraging. And yeah.
To live is Christ and to die is gain.
Read the Bible.
046682388. Yeah, just stay strong, you know, don't be influenced by you know, whatever comes up in your life, you know. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible told me so.
I love all you guys. And that hopefully we can hang out soon.
I would say if you don't believe in Jesus Christ, you got nothing to gain. If you do believe in Jesus Christ, you got everything to gain. You got eternal life to gain.
Stay in the Word, stick together as brothers, and yeah, just really live for Christ. Don't compromise, don't sell out, and be good to your mother.
Probably the most thing that stands out is that you can trust Him no matter what, like no matter how or what things you do, He can always like forgive you.
Is that nothing can separate you from the love of God, and as a Christian you are on the winning team.
Just be really honest to your youth group leaders and tell them if you're struggling, because they can really help you and be a great benefit to your walk with Jesus.
Aim for the West.